Welcome back to JR Pro Shop Vids, everyone. Today we have an interesting experiment featuring Jimoo. Oh yeah, Jungle Barks. So we all know that bowling ball layouts matter. Where your holes are in comparison to the PAP and the pin. And in some cases, the mass bias if it's an asymmetrical bowling ball. So today we have Jimoo throwing the radical sizzle, and we've drilled three holes for his fingers in a triangular pattern, which will allow him to grip the ball six different ways and therefore six different layouts and six different ball reactions. Jimoo's gonna do the experiment today because he's a two-handed bowler, no thumb, and this is the only way you can really do that. Sorry, Simu.
So in the past, this type of drilling layout was legal. You could use it in competition. Things have changed. With the new balance hole rule, with Jimoo having two fingers in the ball, it creates an extra hole, which is not being used by one of his fingers. We can't deliver a ball like this, we can't use a ball like this in sanctioned competition. Another rule change for bowlers who don't use their thumb, the center of grip has to be marked with either a plus or an X, and this needs to be located below the bowler's palm. So to have six different configurations here, we couldn't have six X's or pluses on the ball. And when this was legal, in tournaments where they had a cap on the number of bowling balls you could enter, this counted as six balls. So if you went to nationals, you can't bring much more than that. For our experiment today, we're going to be bowling on 42 feet chromium. This is going to be similar to your typical house pattern.
So the first layout we're going to use is Jimoo's favorite. Pin up, right above the ring, 45 by 4.5 by 55. It'll be just pretty close to his IQ tour. Maybe a little bit more snappy off the end of the pattern, but otherwise pretty close. Let's go give it a shot and see what it does. So we just saw Jimoo throw a few shots. What did you see out there, Barks?
Pretty much exactly what you described. Longer and snappier, similar to his IQ Tour, maybe a little bit further down the lane, but definitely a defined hook shape off the end of the pattern. So Jimoo had some shots that missed a little bit left, a little bit right, but still went through the pins really well, regardless of where he kind of threw it. Very versatile layout for him.
Blind. Layout number two, we're going to use the same finger holes and flip the ball upside down. So now the pin is below the finger holes. We mapped it out. This layout is 6.5 by 135. So I predict this ball to go really long and be really, really smooth, but still hook a little bit and still have some continuation through the pin deck. Let's go see how it looks. All right, Jimoo just threw a few shots with the pin down layout. Barks, what do we see out there?
Surprisingly controllable and smooth for him. So covered about the same amount of boards, maybe one or two less. Didn't finish as high flush as the pin up layout did though. Finished a little bit light in the pocket a time or two, kind of a swish zone there. Pin carry was phenomenal on it though.
All right, so we're about halfway through the video. Question time with Jungle. Question is, if when you get a new ball, you slap the same layout on everything, or do you like to change it up? You like to try different things, try new layouts, try new shapes? Let me know down in the comments. So next layout, we have the pin to the right and up above the fingers, just a hair. This layout turns out to be 2 5/8 by 95. Keep in mind, Jimoo's gonna play on the same line, or try to at least, for all of these shots, all these six layouts. So after mapping out the numbers, I predict this ball to be really early and really, really smooth and hook less for sure than the previous two layouts, maybe 3 to 4 boards. So Jimoo, let's go give this a toss and check it out.
All
we're back from Jimoo throwing a few shots. Barks, what did we see out there?
So like most shorter pin layouts, we saw a lot less overall hook playing the same line. A couple times there, he barely got back to the head pin, left a lot of two pins. A lot less continuation, very smooth shape overall. It's definitely a type of shape that Jimoo can play with, but maybe not on such a long pattern, but on shorter patterns, it's gonna be money for him. Yeah, surprisingly, this actually could be a layout we might use for him.
Next up, we have the pin to the right and slightly below the finger holes. This layout turns out to be 4x130. I predict this layout to fit right in between the previous two, so right in between the pin up and the pin to the right. It's gonna be a little bit stronger than the shorter pin layout and be a little bit more continuous as well. But definitely won't hook as much as the standard pin-up layout that Jimoo likes on his regular stuff. Predict Jimoo to hit the pocket with this layout. He just might be swish zone, maybe leave some weak 10s or some swisher 7s, stuff like that. So let's go check it out. Jimoo just threw this fourth layout. What do we see out there?
Very similar to the previous one, actually. Just a little bit more continuation down lane and a couple more boards of overall hook. Where the previous layout struggled to make it back to the head pin, we managed to hit the pocket on this one.
So for these last two layouts here with...
My appetite, don't leave me.